Samsung has started the One UI 8 beta program for Galaxy S25 customers in several regions. The beta is presently accessible in the US, UK, Germany, and South Korea via the Samsung Members app. Unlike the problematic One UI 7 rollout that encountered many delays and stability difficulties before ultimately achieving a stable release in April 2025, Samsung is adopting a completely different strategy with the One UI 8. The business is aiming an aggressive summer 2025 stable release timeframe, perhaps coming as early as July, months ahead of Samsung's regular autumn upgrade cycle. This expedited development cycle corresponds with Google's earlier-than-usual Android 16 rollout, scheduled in June 2025, making Samsung among the first vendors to give the newest Android experience to people. According to a Samsung source, development teams are working swiftly to perfect the One UI 8 based on Android 16. The business plans for a July-August 2025 launch, corresponding with Google's earlier Android 16 version anticipated for June 2025. The objective is to get One UI 8 out the door in record time while maintaining reliability and rich features, the insider revealed. Samsung learned valuable lessons from One UI 7's delays and is applying them for a smoother, faster rollout. When queried about Google's participation in this expedited development, the insider's reaction was simply yes, a striking proof of intensified Samsung-Google cooperation. This agreement allows speedier incorporation of Android 16 features like the new built-in desktop mode shown at Google I/O 2025. The improved collaboration places Samsung ahead of competition. The date fits well with Samsung's next foldables, the Galaxy Z Fold 7 and Z Flip 7, planned in July 2025. These smartphones will launch with Android 16-based One UI 8 preloaded. The stable version, planned around July-August 2025, will roll out first to the S25 series, followed by other flagships, including the Galaxy S24, Z Fold 6, and Z Flip 6, with mid-range smartphones following behind. By stressing speed, stability, and innovation, Samsung suggests it's done playing catch-up. For Samsung, the One UI 8 signifies not simply a software upgrade, but a strategic repositioning that might change Galaxy users' expectations for future releases. The full rollout of the One UI 8 will bring an AI experience that will make your daily smarter and more easy by strengthening the AI capabilities initially launched in the Galaxy S25 series. There are three primary aspects that actualize this: multimodal capabilities, UX adapted to diverse device form factors, and personalized, proactive recommendations. Intelligent multimodality allows you to have natural, seamless conversation with AI that knows what you're looking at or viewing in the present. The redesigned UX is built for the diverse form factors throughout the Galaxy device family, enhancing your daily productivity and efficiency. The One UI 8 will also identify your context, delivering tailored, proactive recommendations that complement your particular daily routine. Features like Now Bar and Now Brief will give even more tailored insights and ideas to help you stay on top of activities and assist your daily routine, using selected AI knowledge. This sophisticated, tailored AI experience did not simply spring out of nowhere. It is made possible by sophisticated security that preserves your data. Samsung Knox Vault combines a dedicated secure processor with secure memory to segregate critical data from the rest of your user data and guarantee that no one else can physically or remotely obtain your personal information. One UI 8 now gives options where you may select to process data entirely on the device, since many of our Galaxy AI experiences employ both on-device and cloud-based AI processing. With openness and user choice at its foundation, the One UI 8 will give a customized AI experience without sacrificing privacy. The One UI 8 is not just about giving the AI experience, but also provides easy, intuitive capabilities meant to make your day-to-day encounters with your mobile devices even more effortless. Auracast 3, a broadcast audio technology based on Bluetooth LE Audio 4, will provide seamless audio connection by QR code scanning and sharing, enabling many Auracast devices 5, including Galaxy Buds 3 and hearing aids, to join a shared audio stream without the inconvenience of a laborious manual setup. Additionally, customer help at repair facilities will be quicker and more easy, owing to QR and NFC-enabled support 6 available immediately in Samsung account. You may now register using QR or NFC without having to write any registration forms, decreasing wait times and streamlining service requests. The Reminder app will be your travel supporter with more easy and straightforward features. If you are planning a vacation to New York with your family, you can manage all your reminders in one spot as soon as you open the app with a UX that is easy-looking even for first-time users. You can also post a list of to-dos for your vacation with the touch of a button. When your hands are full with shopping bags, you may use your voice to set reminders on the fly since it is voice-enabled. Sharing memories with family and friends will also be simpler than ever with updated Quick Share. Seven, a simple press of the Quick Share button in the Quick Settings panel will enable you to swiftly transmit and receive files. The future of Galaxy AI begins today. Sign up using the Samsung Members app to be among the first to experience the power of One UI 8. Next, three things I enjoy about the One UI 8 beta, and one thing I despise. When I woke up this morning, I didn't anticipate the One UI 8 beta to be waiting for me on my Galaxy S25. Yet that's exactly what occurred. So with my coffee in one hand and my S25 in the other, I spent my Wednesday morning downloading Samsung's newest beta software. The One UI 8 isn't quite as substantial an overhaul as the One UI 7 is, but that's not to say there aren't any important new features. In the 24 hours I've been using the beta, I've spotted a couple of fairly excellent improvements. Here are a few things I enjoy about the One UI 8 beta, plus one thing I despise. Without a question, my number one favorite new feature in the One UI 8 beta is the new 90-10 split-screen option for multitasking. This is really an Android 16 feature rather than anything particular to the One UI 8, but as it isn't included in the Android 16 QPR One beta, it's the first time we've got hands-on experience with it. One UI 7 already allows a lot of options for how you want to divide two programs you're running concurrently. However, the farthest you can go is a 70-30 split. It's not bad, but it may still make certain applications seem squashed and difficult to navigate. With the new 90-10 option in the One UI 8, you may now run one of your applications in a largely full-screen view, while your other program is concealed as a little sliver at the top or bottom of the screen, and you can instantly move that app to the full-screen view simply by touching on it. This is essentially similar to how Open Canvas works on OnePlus phones, and I couldn't be happier with it. Now, I can utilize one program without degrading its UI, while yet having another application only a swipe away. It's far and away my favorite method to utilize split-screen multitasking on Android, and I'm pleased to finally have it on Samsung phones with the One UI 8. For the last several months, Google Tasks has been my go-to reminder and to-do list tool. I don't see that changing anytime soon, although the new Samsung Reminder app in One UI 8 is enticing me. Samsung has totally revamped the app's homepage, with the most noteworthy update being the inclusion of new categories at the top. Previously, the One UI 7 presented your own reminder categories at the top, while categories like Today, Scheduled, Important, and Place were stashed away in a side menu. Now, all of them are front and center at the top of the Reminder app, enabling you to easily see how many reminders are in each of those categories. The UI for adding a new reminder is improved too. There are additional reminder choices. Adding a time to a reminder is a lot easier, and the location UI is also enhanced. Additionally, if you use the Samsung Calendar app, you may now set a new reminder from there. It's a lot of tiny adjustments, but I believe they all come together to make Samsung Reminder a significantly more delightful experience than it used to be. As someone who doesn't live that deep in the Samsung environment, the larger availability of Google Tasks will certainly keep me there for the time being. Still, this is a big boost on Samsung's side, and I hope it pushes Google to give Tasks similar attention. This is a very modest adjustment compared to the multitasking and reminder changes, but it's still one that I enjoy. If you're using the One UI 8 beta and share anything via Quick Share, you'll see that there's now an entirely new interface. In the One UI 7, selecting the Fast Share toggle from the Fast Settings just presented a pop-up menu allowing you to decide who may share files with you. However, with the One UI 8, hitting the identical quick share choice now brings you to a fresh new interface that's separated into discrete receive and send pages. Additionally, from the Send tab, you may pick files you wish to share right there, rather than needing to do it via Android's standard sharing option. The innovation behind Quick Share is amazing, but its user-facing appearance on Android has always been terribly inadequate. This is a major step in the right direction, and I honestly believe they'll get me to utilize Quick Share more frequently. This is something we anticipate all Android phones to ultimately have. But if you want to test it now, you'll only find it in the One UI 8 beta. All the finest improvements from the One UI 7 are still here. Samsung is making modest but beneficial improvements to several of its first-party applications, and adding other Android 16 features to the mix, such enhanced multitasking, resulting in the One UI 8 being a really excellent upgrade in my opinion. Would it be even better using Material 3 Expressive? Absolutely. But even without it, I'm delighted to see where Samsung is heading with the One UI 8. So that's all we know for now. We'll be sure to keep you updated as soon as we have more information. Thanks for watching.